at PPG Paints Arena as the Penguins hope to hop back in the win column in a matchup with the Columbus Blue Jackets. In your opening faceoff, brought to you by number one Cochran, go one better. The puck is dropped and we're underway for the Pens and Jackets, the third of four this year, the beginning of a five-game homestand here tonight at PPG Paints Arena as Brian Dumoulin plays it off the curved glass in the Columbus bench, and the puck's out of play 8 seconds in. Back to Kent Johnson at the right point. Throws it down low. A centering pass blocked off by Petrie. Deflects high in the air. Gloved down by Blankenberg at the left point. Across Johnson into the slot for Sillinger. Turns and throws it left wing. Shooting is Bemström. He scores. Off the post and in from the left wing circle. A power play goal from Columbus. And they lead it 1-0.
Well, pretty good puck movement.
I would agree.
Hey, you had the pump out guy. I believe that was Johnson, the bump-out guy, who just held on to the puck and...
Sillinger.
Excuse me, I beg your pardon, it was Cole Sillinger. And he finds that bump-out guy, Bemström, and the one-timer. I thought Tristan Jarry was a little slow, moving from his left to right. That puck was right on the ice, and it snuck between the post and the right skate of Tristan Jarry. And it's 1-0 Jackets.
Down low from Malkin. Swoops to the near side. Right circle for Ruda. Fans on the shot. Look out. Here come the Jackets the other way. It's Liam Foudy. Down the left side with a step at the near circle. Throwing it in front. Save. Jarry rebound. They score. The follow-up attempt from Lane Peterson slams it in atop the crease. And the Jackets have a 2-0 lead with 7:54 gone in the first.
Wow. We warned you. We warned you, Josh. This team has come to play. And some of the bad habits that the Penguins have, they're getting exposed right now by the team with the worst record in the National Hockey League. Worst in the East, anyways. And they are sticking it to the Penguins good here. That's two goals on five shots. Tough to blame Tristan Jarry on this one here. A shank shot by Jan Ruda, and bam, they're off to the races. And the Penguins can't sort it out. Tristan Jarry makes an initial save, I think, off his own man on the cross-crease pass off the shoulder, but can't control the rebound. And it's 2-0 Jackets.
A sidestep Boqvist handed off to Malkin. His pass knocked down by Kent Johnson. Flipped to center. Roslovic after that. Down the left side. Has a step on Pettersson in the net on the forehand. Centers in front of shot. They score. Patrick Laine atop the crease. And the Columbus Blue Jackets with an all-out blitz. Up 3-0 with 9:49 to go in the first.
More self-inflicted pain. Errant pass by Evgeny Malkin. And they're just gone. They're all over the Penguins. And what a play here by Jack Roslovic. Josh, I knew he was going to do this. As soon as he came to the net, he looked over his right shoulder. And he saw Laine.
Lane Peterson back in his own end. Skips it to Blankenberg. Feeds it forward for Bemström. He carries over the line right wing. Cross ice pass for Foudy. Wrist shot scores. Liam Foudy with a dart from inside the left wing circle. And it's 4-0 Columbus.
Wow. This is a 2-on-3, Josh. And we might be getting a goaltender change here. That's four goals on 12 shots.
Casey DeSmith just went down the tunnel.
Yeah. And Tristan Jarry is moving from his left to right, down early. And Foudy goes upstairs, short side on Tristan Jarry. It's 4-0 Columbus over the Pittsburgh Penguins in Pittsburgh. And here comes Casey.
Four goals against on 12 shots for Tristan Jarry. And with 2:37 gone in the second period, he's out. Casey DeSmith enters the game for the Penguins. His team, though, far from sick tonight, 4-0. I guess the cool kids would say they're playing sick, the terms they're using. Penguins back in the attacking zone. Malkin centers in front. Zucker on the backhand puts it home atop the crease. And there is some life, and who else to supply it? Jason Zucker, his 20th of the year. It's 4-1 Columbus.
Are you surprised?
Absolutely not, Borky.
Penguins lost his faceoff. But just a great job by Marcus Pedersen. The pinch down the left wall, and then the grind starts. Nice little pass by Evgeny Malkin from below the goal line, and the patience of Job in front of the net by Jason Zucker to know I have half a second. There's no blue jacket on me. Let me stop this puck, corral it for a second, be strong on my stick, get forehand, backhand, elevate the puck. Okay, baby, it's 4-1.
In that second period, as does Michael Hutchinson, who waits for the Penguins to come down ice. And here they come down the right side. Shooting is Gensel. He scores! That is just what the doctor ordered. Jake Gensel inside the near post. 21 seconds into the third. It's 4-2.
That was special. That's a special talent to do that. I call that the Sergei Fedorov. As you slide it through the triangle, right, Josh? And you pick it up on the other side, and this thing finds a hole.
Wow.
I don't know how it ended in the goal, but Jake, left-hand shot, right side of the ice, comes down on Blankenberg, and Blankenberg sticks his stick out, set up the triangle. He slides it through the triangle between the stick and the skate, picks it up on the other side, and just chips it. It finds a hole, six holes, short side, blocker side on Hutchinson. Just what you needed. It's 4-2. Don't go anywhere.
Over the line. Left wing. Stops. Goes to the far corner. Lost the puck there. Comes behind the net. Bayreuther turns it over. Atop the crease. They score! Jason Zucker taps it in. Right on top of the blue paint. He's got two. And it's 4-3 Columbus.
Here we go.
Uh-oh.
Here we go. All the heavy lifting here was done by Jason Zucker, just getting the puck in the zone. And Evgeny Malkin with a great forecheck. First, forcing the turnover by Bayreuther. And then following up on the play was Jason Zucker, who gets the cookie, goes upstairs over the right hand, the glove hand of Michael Hutchinson. Oh, baby, it's 4-3. Giddy up. Let's go. And Columbus is going to use their timeout.
Carries behind the net and sends it to Pedersen, left wing. He'll lift it. Cross ice for Crosby. Over the line, right side, into the slot. Drops the right wing. Raquel holding, throwing in front. They score! Danton Heinen slams it in. Down 4-0. The Penguins tie this game at 4. Who is writing this script?
I tell you, when Marcus Pedersen made this great outlet pass to Sidney Crosby, you had a feeling.
Absolutely.
You had a feeling like, oh, wait a minute here. And Sid was able to flag it down on the backhand, gain the offensive zone, little drop pass to Ricard Raquel. Great patience by Raquel to hang on, get to the goal line, send it cross crease to Danton Heinen, who pops it in. We're tied at 4.
10 seconds to go in regulation. Jeff Petrie. Back behind his own net, glances up at the clock. He'll feed it left side for Dumoulin. Final seconds tick down, and the Penguins have tied this game at 4 after 60 minutes of play and being down 4-0, and they will look to complete the comeback in the Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield overtime. He'll walk the line to the center point, throws it down low, deflected wide by Gensel. Loose puck below the goal line. Robinson can't clear. Malkin's got it at the right point. Into the high slot with it. Across Crosby. One-timer scores! The captain completes the comeback. And Pittsburgh, from down 4-0, wins it 5-4 in overtime.
One-timer, 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 one-timer. Thank you for the one-timer. Sid, and the decision by Mike Sullivan to keep the big boys out there, even though they were tired. They went to the reserve tank, Josh. They had just a little extra. And Sid pounds that one-timer past Michael Hutchinson for the OTW on the PP.
Ladies and gentlemen, Elvis has just left the building.